predict they're looking to extend their three-game winning streak in this fourth-round game between the USC Trojans and the Baylor Bears.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Bears are clearly outmatched on paper in this one, Dick. What's the key to pulling off a victory for them?
Here are a couple keys, Brad. First of all, be strong with the ball. Turnovers can be the story here tonight, so protect that basketball. Second of all, it's imperative that you win the battle of the boards. And lastly, be aggressive defensively. Don't give them any open looks.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. A high screen. Well, Dick, that didn't take very long.
I tell you, they're quick out of the gate, baby.
Trying to pack it inside for the bucket. Perfectly executed. Both teams looking to get things going here. The power forward receives the pass. Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Goes up for two and off the mark. Working it around the perimeter. Inside. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. On the outside.
Watch out. 5 second call approaching.
He shoots from the top of the key. That's good. With a little baby hook.
I tell you, the jump hook, so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. It was a good thing he got fouled off that pro hop. I can tell he wanted to do something nasty, Brad.
Two shots. Hits that one.
Makes those free throws count. Wants to go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby. Defense!
Defense! On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Fed the low block. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
The skip pass is picked off. Number zero is animated and ready to go.
I love seeing players play with emotion and passion. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that.
Inside. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Ball was loose, but the offense got it back. They work the perimeter. Number zero handles the pass. He drains the shot.
That's a 7-0 run.
Bucket. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Right now, it's a one-man show. The other players need to step up.
Way out on top, controlling the ball, and he'll kick it back outside.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Number 13 is called for the foul. Shows patience waiting for the reset. Well, the defense defender goes down, but there's no call either way.
Wow, no call right there. I think that was a good call though, by the official.
Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. He comes away with it. Here they go into transition. And the jam. Number 22 receives the ball.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Good job defensively. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. He looks for the bomb. They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
The power forward handles the feed. And he missed. And he scores despite the hack. They're working around the perimeter. That's a foul. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
He is going to the line. First one, good. He misses the second. Boy, terrible execution on offense. High post player flashing.
High post screen, gonna use it?
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Number 22, the bucket counts and one.
Hey, great composure to take the foul and still get the shot off.
With the free throw. He gets it to go. He'll regroup the offense. Well, that's good defense. A steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
He keeps the dribble as they reset. He takes the shot. Sinks it. Teams are looking to get something going here. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play. Set that screen away.
The kick out. Got it. He gets the foul and the bucket.
That's how you do it when you want to win, baby.
Great play. What a play. Demonstrating unbelievable skill. Now look at him. He's celebrating with the cheerleaders.
Hey, he's out of control, Brad. He wants everyone to get up and enjoy the moment, including the cheerleaders.
Number 50 going to the charity stripe for the first time tonight. In. Dick, it's really been a while since I've seen a team shoot like this.
Hey, every once in a while you get a squad that gets on a tear and simply makes your jaw drop. It's fun to watch, isn't it, Brad?
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Here he comes defensively on him in the low block, Dick.
I tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but Benny does a great job in post position of spreading his body and getting the ball.
This one might have been over before it started, Dick.
Yeah, it's been one-sided so far. Still plenty of time left, though.
A work it inside, and he tries a drop step defensively. Nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Tries for two.
I love this sky hook. You cannot block that shot. He gets that ball in deep. Hey, Brad, why don't more guys use it?
There's the fake. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
The ball goes out of play. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick down here on the sidelines. It looks like the losing team is starting to get a little bit anxious. Their coaches are reminding them just to relax. My observation is it looks like these bright lights have gotten the best of this team so far in the first half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. In and out. For two. Can't get the shot to go. There's a high screen. And the ball goes out of play. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
He goes with a jump hook. And in and out. Gave it up. He unloads off the rim and no good. Well, this isn't the contest we expected so far.
This is turning into a blowout, baby. Somebody better find some heart and start doing the little things.
Harm and foul. Post flashes up high if he wants it. Goes up for two. The lay-in.
They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
Didn't give it to him down low. Going the other way. He makes a nice shot fake.
High post screen.
Working it around the perimeter. He throws it up from downtown. Way off target. Tries to get the D to bite. He attempts a jump hook. Doesn't go. Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first initially he wants a three-pointer. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebound position, a good block out. And that's essential in a post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately a block out and get good rebound position.
And he'll kick it back outside. Nick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
You're right, Brad. There is a mismatch.
From the baseline, the number 32 was a top recruit coming out of high school. Personally, I can't wait to see how he's going to develop.
He was highly recruited out of high school. Hopefully, he'll continue to develop and really blossom into something special.
For two, they still don't score. He does the sweet fake shot. On the dribble, gives it up. Defense giving some room. Whoa, not a good decision to take that shot.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
fake. Got a nice screen. 10 on the shot clock. On the inside for the bucket. And he missed. He nails the shot. He shoots from the top of the key. He gets it to go. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
To draw the charge, and even he has to smile about this one.
I tell you, kidding me? That's one of the great acting jobs of all time. Get him an Oscar.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Post flashes.
The frustration right there.
Goes up for two.
Look at that try.
There, that's more like my stuff.
Wow. What a Baryshnikov right there. You always were a dancer.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Jumps into the defender.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He sinks another basket. What are they going to do with this guy, Dick?
I don't know, Brad, but they better do it quickly.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Pump fakes. He squares up down to the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Court.
Dump it inside. Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball in the deck. Where's he going?
Great shot. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Shot clock is dead. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Takes the board.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break.
He shoots from the elbow. He hits it. Time, the Trojans are trailing by 10. If you missed the play of the half, here's another look. Baylor had an awesome first half shooting the ball, Dick. Can we expect more of that in the second half, you think?
Hey, with the composure they're showing on the floor, Brad, I wouldn't doubt it. This is a very methodical team.
A check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. He can't miss.
Finish up, man. Feeling it, Brad.
Picked off.
Pass is stolen.
Terrific gamble on the interception. On the outside, the shooting guard gets the ball. He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on the defensive end. Mr. Excitement with that jam. High post screen. So effective, that screen.
Number 32 with the foul. First personal foul. And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
Out there, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
It up. He knocks down another bucket.
This kid's got skills, Brad. Up and inside.
In the paint. Trying to draw the foul. Number 14 with a finger roll. He better get rid of it. Ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Too strong. We're going to move it around the perimeter. For two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Takes the pass in the paint. Number 50 comes up with it. Working around the perimeter. For the deuce. No good. He rejects it. There's a bad pass right to the defender. Goes for the steal down low, and he didn't get it.
I tell you, he took a chance, and he lost, baby.
USC are showing signs of a good run here, Dick.
They look like they put it together for a moment. Hey, let's see how long they can keep it up.
He looks for the bomb.
Man, he ran his man right into the screen to get off that nice jumper.
Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Away the pass. And a shot block. The Bears have got to continue to get him the ball.
Daddy's on fire.
Pass it stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? On the outside. Steals the pass. Look out. Here we go. He shoots. Off the rim and no good.
Trying to get that ball movement. Get that good spacing. Gonna take some play on the defensive end.
They're nailing three balls at will right now.
They're really hurting them with the three-point shooting.
He up fakes.
Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
Jumped in front to take it away. Looking for a good shot. In the post. Gave it up. Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Number 32 steals the ball. Working it around the perimeter. Now they work it around the perimeter. He intercepts it. Whistled for the foul. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me? If you want to know how aggressive a team is, you check to see how many times they go to the free throw line. That's a great indicator.
Baylor are on a nice little run at the moment, partner.
They have to remember solid defense leads to good offense, which is what we're seeing right now.
Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
They'll work it around the arc. He blocks the shot. He gets the rejection. Pushes it. Trying to draw some contact. Grabs the rebound.
Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court.
The pop shot rejected. They'll bring it up. A little bit of a collision there, but no foul called there.
I take a good call by the official. Not blowing a whistle. I think it's an excellent call.
Another turnover.
We're not talking apple turnovers either.
For the bucket. Oh, yes. Be a change in the game plan right now, Dick.
Could be. Got to be ready for anything if you're the opposition. Tempo of the game really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Steals the ball. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Leans in. He puts it in with contact and all. The small forward with the ball.
Nice fake.
There's a double team waiting there. He tries the three ball. Rims out. The power forward gets the pass. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot. He did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, the crowd certainly hoped for a closer matchup. One side of the arena is celebrating in the stands, and the other one is just sitting there in complete disbelief, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Looking for a good shot. On the dribble, gives it up. For two. Up. Easy one. Gave it up.
There's the trap.
Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Sinks it. Here they come with a double team to stop it.
Great screen set up, but the shot won't go.
On the outside, Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
Is this defense ever quick to recover?
It's poor conditioning, Brad.
Intercepted. Spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Tries for two. Doesn't go. Sets a screen for his teammate. Perfectly executed. Are they confused about who goes where on that double team?
Oh, there's no doubt.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Working it around the perimeter.
Up and inside.
He shoots from long range. Off the rim and no good. They work it around the perimeter. Gliding in for the jam.
Sliding and gliding. Nobody rotated over. The defense moves so slowly.
Number 50 with the fake.
Got to think right now. Got to focus defensively.
The small forward takes the feed. And he'll kick it back outside. On the dribble, gives it up. They move it into the front court. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Fakes the shot.
Double team now, bad angle. Turnover City, and I'll always really negate any offense.
They work the perimeter. Entry pass in the paint for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
For the deuce. They still don't score. Puts it up, looking for contact. Bucket in and out. Fans will be celebrating tonight, Dick. This one's out of reach.
That's what the fans came to see. Their team win. 5 points, 10 points, 20 points. It doesn't matter.
He got fouled and the bucket.
He took it about himself, Brad. Big play, big time score.
Dick, look at this. He's not afraid to let anyone know how he feels.
Brad, the players are feeling it, and they want everyone to know that they're feeling it.
How important is it to get to the free throw line?
Well, you know, those bonus points, Brad, you get those simple points. They add up at the end. Plus, you get people into foul trouble. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
He shoots from outside. Rims out. With a deep pass. Great defense.
Boy, he puts pressure on a defense. What a great point guard. I love point guards that could really attack the defense.
offense on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. Looking for contact. Was that beautiful or what?
Look at that great defense right there. Not allowing them to make the turn.
He shoots from the elbow. Off the rim and no good. Takes the shot, rims out. Defender knocked the ball loose, but the offense got it back. Picks off the lazy pass. Gave it up. He shoots from the top of the circle. Off the rim and no good.
Pushing that basketball. Up and inside.
Goes up for two. He is just lighting up there.
He's beating his man to the spot and hit the shots, Brad.
At
the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
It's stolen.
What a great strip.
He shoots from downtown. He hits the shot.
Trying to funnel him to the sideline, take him to a trap.
Number 22 is charged with the foul. Third team foul. Well, Dick, the shots seem to be dropping for him right now.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. They're dropping, and you better have good productivity out of your front court. When you have that balance inside-outside, you got a great chance to win. And you have to have post players that are going to make big plays.
There's a double team waiting there. Now they work it around the perimeter. On the dribble, gives it up. Dick, I think the better team won, we can say that. And it's heartbreak for the other club, but, you know, you've got to win it and keep on going to get to that final Monday night in April.
Well, I'll tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Baylor wins and reaches the end of the road. These are the last road games of the season.
Hey, two wins are all they need, Mr. Nestler. And it's all they're thinking about as this team advances to the magical Final Four.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler saying so long.